and welcome to VR Reviews.
October of Terror!
Today we'll be reviewing the Spawn Series 27 Art of Spawn Clown. So, yes, this concludes October of Terror for this year. Sorry I wasn't able to do it all month long like last year, but I only have so many horror-themed things, and I'm stretching it using him for October of Terror this year. The clown is, you know, he's fairly horrifying. Look at him. But either way, let's talk about the actual figure. He is a fairly standard older McFarlane Spawn figure, really nicely sculpted, practically no articulation, basically plastic statue. Either way, he is really cool. So let's go ahead and zoom in for the articulation, sculpt paint details, all those sorts of things.
Alright, starting with a quick size comparison, of course here we have Clown. Here is our standard Marvel Legends 6-inch Superior Spider-Man and 3¾-inch Marvel Universe Wolverine. Of course, Clown is on a base, so that does make him a bit taller, but he still is really not in the 6-inch scale. He's closer to 7, maybe even 8, because he's actually really even bigger than I thought he was, because Clown's supposed to be short. So he's really not in scale with either of these two here. He may be in scale with some other Spawn figures, but I don't have enough Spawn stuff to really compare him to. Anyway, let's get the other two out of here and just look at Clown. Alright, moving on to our 360 spin. Here you can see Clown. He is wearing sort of a dark denim kind of jacket. The texturing on it's really good. Lots of clothing wrinkles. It's rolled up on the sleeves. And then he has bare forearms, a big bulky sort of arms, and then his hands are in holding positions for his accessories. He has on a shirt, which is pulled up quite a bit, and he's got his belly poking out there. That's all nicely sculpted and detailed and painted and everything like that. He has on some short jeans there, and then he has sort of wrappings around his feet. You can see his toes poking out there at the end. Once again, really good sculpted detail there on the wrappings and on the feet as well. And then he has his base, which he is attached to. And it's got sort of lots of various debris and rubbish and skulls and things attached to it. Overall, the detail work is really, really good, which is what you would expect from McFarlane, as that is one of their key selling features, is the fact that their detail is exorbitantly good. Now let's go ahead and zoom in on Clown's head sculpt. Zooming in on Clown's face sculpt, as you can see, the detail on it is also really nicely done. He has his sort of design, his blue face paint there. He's got sharp teeth inside the mouth, and that's all painted and detailed very well. He's got orange eyes, and then he's bald mostly on top, and then he's got little tufts of white hair, and those are actually little faux pieces of hair. So they can just kind of end up all over the place if you don't sort of try to position them. But they're poking out in unusual fashions, which Clown's hair tends to do. Overall, facial detail is, of course, excellent. It is very cool. Now, let's go ahead and zoom out and look at some articulation. Unfortunately, articulation is the point where most McFarlane figures tend to fall short. He has very minimal articulation, cut wrists and cut elbows, and then he has ankle cuts down here, which are fairly irrelevant because he's always going to be attached to this base. So pretty much you're just going to be able to change slightly the position in which he's holding his accessories. Speaking of those accessories, let's go ahead and move on to those. First off, Clown comes with some bones, which are meant to be shoved into his hands like this, as if you don't put them in there, they look a bit strange, just sort of sitting there holding nothing. You attach that one that way, and this one you put in this way, which has a little peg in the center. And that is how you do that. Very cool little bones. They have very nice detail and paint work on them, and they certainly make the little figure look a lot better. And after that, you just have sort of extra rubbish to attach to the base. You have this little sort of garbage can lid here on a stick. And then you have this assortment of pots and pans, which you attach over here. You just kind of peg those into the base, and that completes him as a figure. Now that wraps it up for Clown and all of his accessories, let's move on to the packaging. Packaging-wise, Clown comes in a fairly standard style of packaging for McFarlane, although McFarlane changes their packaging up regularly. It's clamshell with your image over here on the side, picture of Clown. New art, Clown 5 down here, Art of Spawn, Series 27. That means it's the 27th Spawn series, not the 27th Art of Spawn series. On the back, you get a little description and pictures of other figures in this series, which are the Vandalizer, two different Spawns, and Wanda. There's actually another Spawn over here underneath this little card thing, and then there's Clown back there. As is usually the case with clamshell packaging, this is good for in or out of package display. So yeah, clown.
Alright, that wraps it up for clown. So until next time, goodbye and happy Halloween.
Hello, you've just watched one of my videos. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed my videos. If you didn't, run away. Run away and never return. Also, feel free to check out my other channels. Venom Raptor for all my variety gaming content, and VR Reviews for reviews of various action figures and collectibles. Thank you, and goodbye.